got a little sister, she probably thinks boys are smarter than her. New research shows that girls start underestimating their gender's intellectual capabilities as early as age 6. So while 5-year-old boys and girls both associate being really, really smart with their own gender, 6- and 7-year-old girls no longer make that connection and often lose interest in games meant for really, really smart kids. In other words, they start to think that brilliance is a boy thing. As girls grow up, things only get worse. They become convinced that subjects that supposedly require brilliance, like math and science, aren't for them. Even high-performing female high school students lack confidence in their ability to solve science and math problems. Of course, girls don't just invent these stereotypes. As early as kindergarten, teachers start to rate girls' mathematical proficiency lower than that of boys with similar achievement and learning behaviors. And it starts even before that. When boys and girls have different toys, they start playing separately and differently at an earlier age. Feminine toys, like dolls and play kitchens, teach organizational language and social skills, skills that suit traditionally feminine careers. Masculine toys tend to focus on large motor development and spatial skills, the foundations for learning math. A gendered environment, even just a stereotypically decorated bedroom, can make a kid believe more in gendered expectations, even if the only difference is color. And no, pink isn't naturally a girl thing. All of this stereotyping limits kids and the adults they become. If girls grow up thinking that math skills and even brilliance are male qualities, it shouldn't be surprising that they rarely dedicate themselves to the so-called STEM subjects. Women comprise just 21% of full science professors and just 5% of full engineering professors. Only 9% of chief information officers are female. The women who do forge ahead in supposedly masculine careers have to battle biases constantly. Faculty members are more likely to mentor a man, classmates are more likely to be impressed by a man, and employers are more likely to hire a man. In the US, women scientists earn on average just 82% of what male scientists earn. There's nothing smart about gender stereotypes that prevent societies from making the most of their members' talents. So why do we cling to them?